Do the easy thing first as a warm-up to ease into the hard thing. The opposite is equally valid. Do the hard thing first because it takes more time, you're fresh. You can work in daytime, stores are open, and help is not out to dinner. Savor good problems. Procrastination is for good problems. If at first you don't succeed, give up immediately. Move on to some other task. When you circle back, your subconscious will have worked on it. Like sleep, only cheaper. Kill bad problems. Bad problems are best solved immediately. When you procrastinate a bad problem, it will sap your mental energy, your focus, and your time. Talk with others and find a solution before the problem consumes any more energy. When you get a parking ticket, for example, just pay it. People often get angry when they are hungry or they have to wait. Although a freak out is absolutely forbidden in the studio, there is virtue in it. After a good, raging freakout, the freaker is spent, calm and humbled. But he's also ashamed. Often he has created yet more problems for himself. Avoid frustration and keep attacking the problem until it dies. Never yell. Scream only if you are hurt and need urgent attention. In order to know when to quit, we must be familiar with the quitting coefficient. We illustrate the quitting coefficient using the following graph. The y-axis represents the progress of your task or project from nothingness to completeness. The x-axis represents the amount of time we spend on our task. This asterisk represents our point of maximum return. This is the optimum quitting point. Notice the vast amount of time between our most productive phase and our point of maximum return or quitting point. In business, we would quit here to maximize profit, but in our business, we must persist. We may want to quit during this diminishing returns phase as our efforts become sluggish, tedious, and heartbreaking, but we press on. After the point of maximum return, our efforts will begin to ruin our work. We rely on our carefully tuned intuition to quit precisely at the point of maximum return, helping to ensure that the fruit of our labor falls within the desired magic zone. Nothing is ever done. But we quit at the point where the work begins to cover up the evidence of the work. The athletic analog to the point of maximum return is just before the injury point. In an athletic endeavor, we aim to train up to, but not beyond, the point of injury. We repeat this process again and again, till death do we part. Thus we never give up learning when to quit. We are mystics, not rationalists. Art, like marathon running, is an irrational, useless endeavor. But we expend the enormous energy art demands anyway. Because through our efforts, we expand our threshold for the human spirit. This is what distinguishes us from the cows in the field.